In the previous video, you saw how there are many things you can consider when you look at configuring your database or managed instance. In this video, we're going to take a closer look at how you can configure something like connectivity using the Azure CLI. So what we have here is I'm in Azure Data Studio, and similar to the SQL notebook you saw in an earlier video with Bob, I'm actually using a PowerShell notebook. So that just means all my code cells are going to run PowerShell, and I'm just connecting to localhost. Now, one thing to note is I can use the Azure CLI or these AZ commands to basically do various tasks with all my Azure resources, not necessarily just Azure SQL Database or Azure SQL Managed Instance. And I can use this in the Cloud Shell, which you'll see in a later module, or I can use the Azure CLI in something like PowerShell, like we're doing here. So in this example, we're going to walk through how you can set up and configure your connectivity to Azure SQL and a brief look at what that impact is on the performance. So first, what I'm doing is I'm using AZ SQL Server Connection Policy Show to get the current connection policy to my Azure SQL Database Logical Server. So what you see is I got the default response. This default response means that for services within Azure, I'm going to use the redirect method, but for services outside of Azure, I'm going to use the proxy method. Now, for this little test that we're going to do, we're going to update the connection policy to proxy. So basically, we want everything to go to the gateway and then go to the database. So what I used is AZ SQL Server Connection Policy Update, and then specified the proxy policy type. And then I'm just, you know, printing out that connection type to confirm that it worked. So now that it worked, we can do kind of an unofficial test to see how it affects performance. So in SSMS, I'm just going to create a new query where I select all from saleslt.product, and I'm going to include client statistics. Now I'm going to run this 10 times, and then we can get a good average to see what our network latency is. So now that it's run, I can go into client statistics, and down at the bottom, I can see the wait time on server replies. Now, if I scroll all the way to the right, what I'm going to see that on average, the wait time on server replies is about 50.67 milliseconds. So basically what this means is it can be an indication to the network latency that I'm seeing. So now if I switch back to Azure Data Studio and we kind of remember that number of 50 milliseconds, what I'm going to do is update the policy to redirect. So remember in redirect, we're going to go to the gateway the first time, but then we're going to go directly to the database after that. So what I've done is use the same command to just to update the connection policy to redirect. And then I'm just printing out the connection type to confirm that that worked. So again, now we're going to do the same exact thing in SSMS, except we are going to do it with redirect and see if there's a change. So I'll include client statistics and run this about 10 times. Now that that's done, I can check the client statistics. Again, look at the wait time on server replies, which is an indication of latency. And what I'm seeing is about 30 milliseconds for wait time on server replies. So with redirect, we were able to get 30 milliseconds of network latency, which is significantly less than the 50 milliseconds that we saw for the proxy connection. Now, this is going to change on your network and your internet connection and a bunch of other things, but what you're going to see is a reduction in that latency with the redirect method. So in this demo, you saw how to use the Azure CLI to configure various things, in this case, SQL connectivity. Join us in the next video.